If you use Kubernetes and you're using a service mesh, then you need to learn how to use OpenTelemetry to make your metrics so much better. Let's say I have a Kubernetes cluster with a front-end, back-end, and database all in different pods. If I add a service mesh to this cluster, like Istio, which I think is the most popular service mesh for Kubernetes, then what that's going to do is add a sidecar proxy to each pod, which intercepts the communication, making it more secure and giving it the ability to manage traffic. But it can also collect data from these communications, so logs, metrics, and traces. And this can all take place without adding a single line of code to any of your services. But there is a slight problem with the way Istio or other service meshes collect telemetry data. So if I wanted to export it to multiple places like Azure, AWS, or GCP, I'd have to do that individually for traces, metrics, and logs. But using the OpenTelemetry collector makes that process so much easier. With the OTEL collector, because everything is in the pipeline, it's easy to add an exporter to send the data to different places. And I can also collect additional telemetry data from the service themselves by adding an OpenTelemetry exporter for metrics, traces, or logs. Let's go through how to add this to an existing project. So I currently have a Kubernetes cluster that I'm running locally with a client that has a backend, a frontend, and a MongoDB database. If I look at the labels for the default namespace, you can see that I've got Istio injection enabled, which means that each pod has a sidecar proxy. So that's why you can see two here instead of one. So if I were to describe the backend pod, you can see that in the init containers, there's the Istio init. And if I scroll down to the actual container, you can see I have my backend container here. I've also configured Jaeger and Prometheus for Istio based on the sample files that were provided when I downloaded Istio. So if I look at all the pods in the Istio system namespace, I should see Jaeger and Prometheus as well as the Istio ingress gateway and Istio D. So this means I should be getting traces in Jaeger and I should be getting metrics in Prometheus. Let's improve this by adding the OpenTelemetry collector. We'll first delete the Jaeger and Prometheus deployments since we don't need them. And because our default namespace has the Istio label, which will automatically add a sidecar proxy to each pod, we need to add a new namespace to add our OpenTelemetry collector pod and our Jaeger and Prometheus pod. So we'll create a new namespace called observability, which we can see here. And now we can add the pods. Now, if you follow the Istio documentation for adding OpenTelemetry, it's going to recommend you use the sample configuration as a starting point. You probably shouldn't do that because this configuration was updated last year at the time of recording and uses the logging exporter, which has now been replaced with debug. So I've gone ahead and made my own. And if you're interested, I'll add a link to the description. But all it does is receives the data, then processes it with a batch processor and has a few exporters. So one for exporting data to the console, one for exporting to Prometheus, and one for exporting to Jaeger via OTLP. And you can see down here that logs are being exported to the console, traces to the console and Jaeger, and metrics to the console and Prometheus. I also have a deployment and service manifest file for the OpenTelemetry collector and a Prometheus file, which has a huge Prometheus YAML file, but also has this OTEL collector and a port, and should have an argument to enable the OTLP receiver. I also have a similar thing in the Jaeger manifest file in the form of an environment variable. In case you're wondering where I got all the information for the Prometheus config file, it's pretty much what's inside the Istio samples folder without the OTEL collector targets. Then we can apply all those files with kubectl inside our observability namespace. If we check our pods, we should see they're all running. And if we check the services, we can see the ports available to us. Let's first use port forwarding with kubectl to expose Jaeger and do the same with Prometheus, which means if we go to the relevant port in our browser, we should be able to see some trace data as well as some metrics data. And we can also see some metrics and trace data inside the console from our OpenTelemetry collector pod. This is really cool, but we can make this even better. Because OpenTelemetry allows us to instrument our source code, we can get trace and metrics data from our actual application and send it to our OTEL collector in the observability namespace. This is using the Node.js auto instrumentation from OpenTelemetry, but if we wanted to, we could just as well add our own custom metrics and traces. Fortunately, both the front end and the back end are both using Node.js, so this configuration is similar in both services. But this means I can get trace and metrics data specific to my application, and I can get extra Prometheus metrics like this HTTP, client duration, and client request metric. And the OpenTelemetry configuration makes it so easy to export all this telemetry data to third parties like AWS, Azure, an even better stack where I can benefit from really nice log filtering, dashboards for my metrics, and alerting for all of my data. So if you're using Istio or any other service mesh in your Kubernetes cluster, then I hope I've given you some reasons to check out OpenTelemetry.